turn to weather now. Again, we are taking a live look. You can see some cars trying to get through this thick fog and low clouds, right, Tracy?
That
it really is scary.
Well. It is scary because people really, I think, don't give fog enough respect. You know, you don't slow down as much as you should. You got a place that you want to get to. But you have to be mindful that we've had some pretty significant accidents along parts of the Central Valley because of dense fog, multi-car pileup. So just give yourself ample space between you and the car in front of you. And here are the areas we're most concerned about. Oroville at zero visibility, 1 mile visibility in Marysville, 1 mile visibility in Sacramento, and 1 mile visibility in Fairfield. Here is a look at the visible satellite showing the opportunity for those low clouds as well as for the fog. That's in Natomas into Sacramento, the Pocket, Woodland, also moving into the Davis area. So let's take a look at some tidbits of information about fog. It is the leading cause of weather-related accidents, but more importantly, those fog-related accidents are motorists who actually know the road, but they're still driving too fast. Is that you? Well, sometimes it's me, being honest. Make sure to use your low beams, but you can go to zero visibility in just a few feet. And fog also gives the illusion of slow motion. So a lot of times people feel like they're moving slower than they actually are. So we are going to have the opportunity for fog, morning fog, especially moving through tomorrow morning and even possibly throughout the duration of the weekend. So just be mindful. Here's a look toward Yosemite with Michael Beatley here. If you have a nice photo you'd like to share, don't be stingy. You can always upload it to the ABC 10 app. So take a look at the afternoon highs. They were pretty cool, especially through the valley with 60 in Sacramento, 62 in Stockton, 63 in Modesto. What gives? Well, they had morning fog and now they got more clouds building in, so they really didn't warm up that much. 68 in Auburn, 70 in Placerville. Well, they had more sunshine today, so temperatures warmed up more. Here's a look at your weather headlines. Dense fog remains in the forecast. Weekend afternoon highs in the 70s. Great weekend to take in that peak fall foliage. And any rain in the forecast? Well, let's take a look. So currently outside, we'll see the 50s through parts of the valley. We'll see the lower 60s in Placerville. And here's a look at the winds. Most of them are fairly calm. We got some light winds, but not enough to mix out all that moisture at the surface, which is why the fog remains. We also got a minor cold front that's going to be moving its way through the area. And I was asking myself, is that going to bring us some rainfall? No, it kind of peters out before it gets here. So our forecast for tonight, clouds increasing in advance of that cold front and more dense fog expected. Now, we do have an upper level low pressure system, a trough coming in. That one's timing out to be coming in around Monday. Will it bring us some rainfall? Take a look. Kind of gets here. It's very non-committal. It gets here and it just falls apart. So no major opportunity for rainfall in the forecast, unfortunately, for the next 5 days. Take a look at this. This is really just like a pittance. Yeah, so nothing major in the forecast, unfortunately. But the good thing is we had that huge atmospheric river toward the end of October, so we're still looking at about a 5-inch to 6-inch surplus. Here's a look at the 10-day forecast heading into the weekend. Still pretty nice and pretty cool next week as well.
All right, Tracy, thank you.